Good afternoon, friends. How are you feeling today? Wonderful, fantastic. By the way, my name is Raghavendra. I am the senior trainer in soft skills, CRT, as well as English for competitive exams in DURGASOFT Solutions. Okay? The number one institution in India. Why we insist on that title number one? Because it is well known fact that not only in terms of quantity is secondary for us. So what is primary is quality. We always give utmost importance for qualitative services in the institution. So that tagline makes always DURGASOFT is the number one institution in India. Okay? So coming to today's topic, soft skills. What do you mean by soft skills? What is meant by soft skills? What do you understand when you hear these terms like soft skills, life skills, people skills? So different terms are used nowadays. So it is attracting the attention of many people nowadays. Let us see. I compare the success with one apple. Imagine that this is apple of success. So in case if you want to get successful in your life, if you want to succeed in your life, there are three things, very very important things are necessary. So what are the three things? I divide this apple into three parts. Can you guess and tell me what are the three important things? Not only in your academics, if you want to get that professional success, career growth, there are three certain things very very vital. First thing is knowledge. Some people, they have got very good knowledge, but second quality is missing, second skill they are lagging behind. What is that second one? Second is talent. Okay? Some people, they have very good talent and they don't have sufficient knowledge. Either knowledge is missing or talent is missing. Some people have the both. They have got very good knowledge and very good talent also, but the third important thing is missing in their life. That is the reason they cannot come into limelight. They remain very ordinary throughout their life. They remain below average personality. So what is the third and most important thing? If you ask a person, what is the only one thing that will make you successful, that will change your entire life? Tell me, what is the only one thing? That is attitude. Okay? Attitude is the very, very vital and important aspect. If you don't have talent and knowledge also, attitude makes a man successful. Okay? So what kind of attitude again? We know some people, they have negative attitude and some people have the positive attitude. So every human being, they are left with some human weaknesses. So how to convert your weakness into your strength? How to convert your negative thoughts into positive? How to neutralize? Some people, they always try to discourage others. Some people, they always try to drag them. Because we know the saying, we were born to succeed. Each and every human being, they were born on the earth with some specific purpose. But The second statement says that we were born to succeed but conditioned to lose. Conditions force the people to lose whatever that achievements they want to attain in their life. So overcoming that and neutralizing these negative thoughts is very, very important. The circumstances you have to keep in mind, because some people they try to discourage, because the basic nature of human behavior is feeling jealous. After all, we are all human beings. People, they have got this kind of emotions, frustration, sorrow, worry, depression, anger. So one needs to get control over their emotions, EQ. People, they believe that IQ is very important in order to become successful in one's life. But at the same time, you should also remember that EQ is equally important. What is EQ? Emotional quotient. So one needs to get control over their emotions. So whatever just now I told, these are all emotions. So you need to get control over these emotions. Okay? So friends, in order to become positive in your life, you need to neutralize whatever the negative thoughts, negative suggestions that your friends always try to implement on you. For example, an incident happened, to understand that different psychologies of people, how they behave in their life. Once there was one exhibition going on. The exhibition is nothing but they were demonstrating some different crabs. You know what is crab? Which is available on the seashore. Okay? So they kept in some beakers. That glass beakers will be there, no? The transparent glass, they can be seen outside. And one beaker, that crabs they were collected from some North India, like Mumbai beach. One beaker, the crabs they were collected from South India, some Vizag beach, some from Chennai, some from Trivandrum, some from Goa, like this. Some 10 to 15 beakers they were kept. Okay, crabs are kept in that glass beakers. What happened is, some people they came and they began protest against this, keeping these crabs in the glass beakers. So they demanded remove all that, free all that crabs outside. You are unnecessarily keeping for a long time, let them go outside. So the organizers asked that people to open that lids. Slowly, one after the other, the lids were removed. So from every beach, whatever that beaker was collected, crabs were collected. Slowly, one after the other, the crabs crawling outside and went away. But one beaker inside, even though the lid was removed, the crabs, they were not coming outside. Then they felt surprised, organizers. And when they saw that when one crab is climbing, the another crab, it is just pulling down. It is pulling the another crab down so that it will not come outside. So what do you understand with this example? People, they are jealous in nature. The basic nature of human behavior is feeling jealous. People, those who are jealous in nature, they don't want to lift themselves up, but they want others, they want to pull others down. So they feel unhappy Not because they don't have something, they feel unhappy because their neighbors have something more than what they do have. Okay? So friends, converting your weakness into your strength. Okay? Some people, they have got some weaknesses in their life, personal life, with regard to their personality. So once there was a sales executive, and he was selling some religious books, some Bibles, and he became that top salesman in that company. Obviously, they invited him to that meeting, annual meeting. So many sales executives were there in that company, hundreds of people were there. But out of all these hundreds, why only this person has become number one sales executive, top salesman? They asked him, what is the secret behind your success? Then he said like this. Actually, he was a stammerer. Stammering means what? He can't utter some words properly. When he starts speaking, somewhere he is stuck up. Okay? So he said like this. I am not criticizing or I am not finding fault with anyone. I am only making a point here. Okay? Don't feel negatively. How he was making that statements, you can listen like this. Whenever he went and used to knock at the door, whoever the person used to open the door, he used to say by showing that Bible, "Madam, you don't have to buy this Bible at all. I can read it for free. It is up to you." How many statements are there? Two to three sentences are there. What he was supposed to say? "Madam, you don't have to buy this Bibles at all. I can read it for free. It is up to you." But since he was a stammerer, no? He used to say like this. "Madam, you don't have to buy this Bibles at all. I can read it for free. It is up to you." "Don't read, we will buy it." Because one or two statements he is reading like this. If entire book he starts reading, you can understand their fate. Okay? They are afraid of listening to that entire reciting or reading of the Bible. They said, "Okay, don't read, we will definitely." So he converted his weakness into his strength. Okay? And once there was one MNC, interviews are going on. Okay, one person came in the very morning. He was waiting outside that interview hall. Since he was the first gentleman, they called him inside. Okay? He produced all his certificates, testimonials, credentials and everything. The panel members, they were completely satisfied by seeing his certificates, his performance and everything. He has got very good experience and he has got talent. All the skills are there. So they wanted to give that job to him. They felt that he is a deserving candidate. But still some more people are waiting outside. So they wanted to see some more people, whether is there any more worthy candidate outside. They said, "Okay sir, you just please wait outside. We will call you afterwards." Then he stood up from his chair. He was about to leave that room. But all of a sudden he stumbled. Okay, stumbling means he stepped on something and he fell down. Then whatever the files, whatever that papers that he was carrying, they were scattered in all directions. Helter skelter. Even some papers, they fell on the panel members also. Then they got very serious. What nonsense is going on here? So if you were in that situation, how would you behave? What would you give answer? Tell me. Generally anyone, they would start shivering, okay? But he used a wonderful skill that in the last session I told. What is that skill? Converting that situation into your favor. That is resourcefulness. The answer what he gave was astonishing. Fantastic answer he gave. Sir, I am extremely sorry, sir. I fell down. For that I feel extremely sorry. But I came and fell in the right company, sir, he said. That immediately on the spot they gave that appointment letter to him. Because he is a deserving candidate. We need not see anyone outside. Even though he fell down, what he is doing, he is appreciating that company, he is appreciating that management. Instead of getting frustration, instead of getting discouraged, okay, instead of getting negative thoughts, he converted that situation into his favor. I am extremely sorry, sir, I fell down, but I came and fell in a right company. So this is what is required. Okay, when situation demands, you should be in a position to convert your weakness into success. Okay?